Yeah. I like a sex machine.
Yeah.
You got to have the
breathe.
Shoot your bone.
Lovely. Release the arms down. We're just gonna walk the feet.
Get up,
so we're gonna step. Just to loosen the knees out and walk the feet. Let's go a little bit faster. Open, close. To the sound of the music, to the rhythm of the music. Much different for you than for me.
Hey, country, you didn't say what you meant. You just changed. Brand new funky.
watch. Hold it up front. We're going to do the chicken movement. So you go forward. Faster, forward, forward, forward. Hold it, back, back. Stop, back. Stop, two more slow ones. One more. Let's go first. And back, back, back. Nice, to the right, right, center. Only right, right, center. Right, center. Just ahead. Let's go fast to the right, right. To the left, left center, slow, left center, to keep looking forward, center, fast, and 8, 7, 6, 5, 3, lovely, we're doing circles, in your own rhythm, just make a big circle to the right, try not to move your shoulders too much, just move your head, stirring over your shoulder, keep looking forward, try not to turn it, other side, so circle towards the left, try not to move your shoulders too much. Good. One more. I know it's tough. Lovely. Hold it there. We're just lifting the shoulders up. So you don't release. Up. Release. Up. Release. Carry on. That rhythm or the rhythm that you're listening to the music to. So remember that. Let's go circling. Circle back. Circle. See if you can move your knees. My knees, my feet are still open wide for my hips. Yeah? And when I bend my knees, they're still bending on top of my feet. Let's do that again. Four more. Back. Chest now, trying to isolate the ribs and then the hips. So it's very good for our back, for our core, but also just to move and let go. They say emotions. So get your chest bone, feel it. That's what you want to move now. We're going to move our chest bone forward and then center. Yeah, I'm going sideways so you can see that my hips are trying not to move. And we're just going, pushing our chest bone forward. Round the spot. just right and enter. Yeah, try not to move the hips, that's where the core comes in. And center, we're doing two more slow ones so you really feel it. Shift the ribs, only the ribs, shoulders are square. And center, one more, shift. And center. Okay, we're going eight fast. Shift. 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 Just to the right. Four more. Four. That's it. Three. Two. One. Let's go to the left. Stop it. And center. Just feel that movement. You're actually doing a little bit of an oblique here. And stretching one side. Contracting one, stretching the other.
You know me loving your wine.
Puff your chest out, then round it. It's really like a cat-cow. Can you make up your mind? Yeah, four more.
Pretty girl, you're taking your
time. And three. Lovely.
Loving your wine.
Two.
Pretty girl, you're giving me signs.
And one. Let's go to the left. You go forward and slowly. And left. This is not easy. Bring it nice back. From 19 or long. And right. Go feel it again. It's like a square. Forward. Stick your chest forward. And you're ready. Push your ribs to the side, then sink them back, and then to the right. Let's move faster. Forward, sir, back, sir, to the left, nice, back, to the right. Let's circle. Yeah, that's it. Just make it roll now. Very good for the wheels. You're giving me signs, and you tell me you don't want me. Can you make up your mind?
You're taking your time.
Why you can see the shoulders you and stay square.
Pretty girl,
you're moving
you're
just the middle part of the
me. Can you make up
love, you hold it in the center. We're going to move our hips just to finish off, okay? So we're going to push our hips forward. I'll go sideways so you see. And then release. So it would be like an imprint when you're lying in the mat. And then neutral. Squeeze. And release. Okay, so we're pushing our hips. Bend your knees, keep your legs open, and release. One more slow. Forward, squeeze your glutes, squeeze your core, and release. We're going fast. Forward, release. Forward, release. Forward, release. That's it. Four, three, two, one. Let's go back. Back, arch your spine, neutral. Up, let's go slowly, so. And neutral. Two more slow ones, so release the movement. You're stretching, contracting. And neutral.
Pretty
one
girl,
more.
You're taking your time. Why back. You do me like this? You know me loving your
and neutral. Let's
pretty
go faster,
girl,
yeah?
You're giving me signs. And then back. You tell me you
neutral.
Don't want me. Can
back.
You make
try
up your mind?
Anything else but your
pretty
hips.
Pretty girl, you're taking your time. Why you do me like this? You know me
can
loving
your
mind.
Can we go all
mind.
The way forward and back
pretty
now?
Girl,
so you
you're
forward,
giving me signs. Then
back.
You tell me you don't want me. Can you
forward,
make up your
all
mind?
The way.
Pretty girl, you're taking your time. Why
can
you
we add some arms to that? So
you're
going to cross forward.
Pretty girl, you're giving me signs. Then you tell me you don't want me. Can you make up your mind?
So when your legs, when your hips are back, your arms cross forward.
You're
pushing your hips forward as your arms go back.
You tell me you don't want me. Can you make up your mind?
Four more. it. Two. And one. Stop it in the middle. We're drawing the circle or the square. How you curve, you look at it. So you're going forward. Let's go slow for one. To the side. Back.
Yeah. Let's go.
To the side. Good.
Daddy.
Forward.
Check.
Work. Side.
Work. Yeah,
back.
I'm not to tap it. Shade the fear.
Stop.
Lulu Majer.
Let's go again.
Then you go spank. Yeah, the swag on a rare. What's cool up here?
Side.
Hello, attempted job. Say, what's running? But daddy. Big shoes. Got.
Let's go faster. Daddy.
Less man.
Forward.
More
back.
What's
back.
That? It's a drop top caddy. What's my
forward.
Name? But
side.
Daddy. Big shoes. Got the club
side.
Banging.
One
less
more.
Man. More baddies. What's
back.
That? It's a drop top caddy.
See, you can roll your hips. Make sure you're to the right, that is.
But not the type, but the type
three,
computer. I don't type computer. Next
two,
was hammer time. See the word.
Let's
shine
do
from
the same
front.
Other side. Then
central
we'll do
bank
sideways.
For inside, I got that.
Forward.
The computer is just land up, papa, come back. But
back.
Daddy know the rush. A slow walk.
And
oh,
side.
God.
So
go
remember, we're
block.
Moving the hips.
You don't
forward.
Have respect.
We'll do it one more slow.
The chairman.
Side.
Director.
Good.
What's my
back.
Name? But daddy.
And side. Let's go faster to the place.
Less
one. And
more
side.
Baddies.
And
what's
back.
That? It's a drop top caddy. What's my
forward.
Name? But
side.
Daddy. Big tunes.
Lovely.
Got
good.
Less
forward.
Man. More
side.
Baddies. What's that? It's a drop top caddy.
Really nice.
Burp, daddy.
One more and then
burp,
we'll roll it.
Burp,
let's go. Roll
burp,
the hips. Make sure
burp,
your knees are bent.
Burp,
and that you're not moving
burp,
too much anything else.
Burp,
obviously your knees move
burp,
a little
burp,
bit. But
burp,
keep them bent. Burp
daddy.
Burp
daddy. Burp daddy. Burp daddy.
What's my name? Delta Mommy.
And one.
Babe.
Okay, we're
big
going
bang.
Sideways.
Check the scoreboard.
To right.
I win. No
stop.
Talia. All my
to
bitches
the right.
Bad. Big
and this is
batty.
Literally
a
core exercise because you're contracting this side, stretching the other. You're just
walking
going
like
right
dog,
and drop.
Sally,
but
these bitches ain't
right
seeing me.
And drop. That's it. Keep your knees bent.
Like a Okada. Brother. Like a Okada.
Four.
Run it up. More brother. If you don't like what I'm saying, bitch. Your father. Kiss this. Took your shit. Always
and one, let's go just
wait
to the left
piss.
Now.
In gear,
left
lift, stick,
and
shift,
a
on the
center.
Tip. Only pleasure
left
is taking knees on
center.
Trips.
Left,
my name?
Left hip
but
towards
daddy.
Your left armpit.
Big
that's the contraction.
Got,
that's the side
less
that's
man.
Working, the other one
more
is stretching. Bodies.
What's that? It's a drop top caddy. What's my name? But daddy.
And
big
one more. Now try and do like a pendulum
less
from one side to
more
the
baddies.
Other.
What's that? It's a drop top caddy.
8, 7, 6.
Burp daddy, 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 burp daddy,
burp daddy, burp daddy, burp daddy,
burp
daddy,
burp
daddy,
burp
daddy, burp
daddy, burp daddy, burp daddy, burp daddy,
it's a bit odd,
yeah.
Isn't it? It's
she
a bit different.
Mona.
It's not odd, actually. It's just different.
Mona. I want to try
your
but to
hip,
run out. Girl, I'm mad if I weave the wrong time.
So the feeling should be quite different. Let's go the other way and we'll stop. Go on. And just roll the hips as big as you can. Four more. Three. Two. One. Lovely. Just come back to the center. We're going to do a few side bends, a forward stretch, a few balances, and do the mat work, okay? So we're going to go down and up. And same side. And up. And side bend. Remember to drop the head. And up. And side. And up. Okay, to the left. Four. Inhale up. And exhale. Inhale up. Exhaling, inhale up. One more, exhaling, inhale up. Good. We're going to go sideways, down, as in a forward stretch, and then come up through the side. Try and lean with your head, you're coming up through the left side. So you're coming up through the side, and back to center. Let's go again to the right. We'll do three more. It's not easy. You want to lean with your head, with the crown of your Let it drop, let it drop. Once you're facing the back, let the crown point towards the floor, and then let your head lift you up. The side of your neck, literally, is like you're hanging from here, coming up through the side. That's it, let the head drop. Let's do two more, let it flow. Now down to the side. Your head is literally drawing a circle. Imagine that, actually. You've got a pencil at the top of your head, and you're drawing a circle from the sides of the room up to the sky, and then down. One more, guys. Drop the head, stretch, roll the spine, stack the stomach in, let everything catch. Lovely. We do it the other side, so it's four. Let the head drop. And then when you can't anymore, that's when you fold. When you can't anymore, you come up through the side, to the right, let the head drop. Lovely. Work with gravity, drop and your breath. That's it, nice. Breathing in as you come up, breathing out as you go down. You've got two more. Down, breathe out. Last one, we're going to stay down, yes? So let the head leave still. Stay with your head in between your legs. You might have to look forward though. Make sure that your feet are a little bit more open. And I would like you to do like if you're wagging your tail. So basically, we're trying to get into our hamstrings by tipping our hips one side and the other. One, can you see my knees are still bent? So you don't need to stretch them, or you can. But you're just moving your hips, and I'll go here, right and left. Side. It's not easy, but it's a nice way to open the hip area. That's it. And you can bend your knees or stretch them. We're going to do about eight more. Seven, six, five.
Circle that foot. Four more.
two, one, and then we're going to grab the knee, turn it out, bring the foot to where it works for us. You can be on the floor, half on the floor, half on the floor, ankle, arms together. Now try and grow out of your hips. Don't sink, grow out of them. Squeeze your knee back, engage your core, push your hips forward. Stretch your arms up. Careful, because it's going to take you out of balance. So make sure you have those lower ribs. Go on, grow out your hips a little bit more, and go on, a little bit more. That's it. 3, 2, 1. Lovely. Drop the arms down. Bring the knee forward, because that helps. Just shake it out. Well done. So that was our funky warm-up. I hope you enjoyed it. We're going to now go to the back of our mat. And it's going to be more standard Pilates now. So, yes, I'm going to drop down the volume of the music. I think that will be more helpful. Make sure that you can, that I can see your mat, and I'll make sure that you can see mine. And we'll start first rolling down, as we always do. Nothing's changed, yeah? I hope that's a nice volume for you. Is that okay, as volume goes? Good, perfect, thank you, Emily. Well, let's do it. Let's go together. Bear with me. Oh, wow, I've got another playlist on, a different one. It's just jumped, bear with me. Feet hip distance apart. Let's start thinking of posture. So feet, toes pointing forward. Just breathe in. Grow from the crown. Let's start breathing out and rolling down. And I'm looking for some music. I'll be with you in no time. Roll all the way down, little by little, as you exhale. Here we are, found it. Once you get down, just like we usually do, hold a second before you walk into your plank. I would like us to twist our head to the right shoulder, making sure that the crown of the head is facing the floor, and then the left shoulder. And again, right shoulder. I know, I like changing things sometimes, don't I? The bit of a shock there. Exhale it to the other side. And then do one of those nodding dogs or maybe four. You need to try and let your head go like a pendulum. All the way, hang in, just shifting forward and back. Hold it there, breathe it, and when you're ready, walk yourself into your back. So finally. Hands right under your shoulders. Bend your knees if that's your practice. So you're doing breathe in and breathe out here. If not, you're doing downward dog and plank. That's a little bit harder. So let's go together. Choose what you're doing. Stick with it. Breathe in. Open the chest and breathe out. Roll whatever position you are in. A C-shaped spine. And then again, breathe in. Stretch your chest. Breathe out. C-shape your spine. That's two. Let me see two more. Breathe in it. That's it. Bend your knees. That's it. Nice, Susan. Breathing out. Rolling forward. Try and roll forward. One more. Breathe in it. As you roll forward, don't drop the hips more than the shoulders. Let me see it. Roll forward. Roll forward. That's it. There. Perfect. And then drop the knees down. Drop the knees down. And we're just going to walk the hands back and just think of sinking into your shoulders and then pushing away. And just do that a couple of times on our knees. Yeah, that's it. Sink and then push. So you're thinking of just sinking into your shoulders or sinking into your lumbar spine too, because you're not supporting the core. Then you're trying to have the stomach back and push it away. Make sure you're always looking towards the floor. And also make sure that your neck is locked, no wrinkles in the skin of your neck. Let's do one more. And now just keep pushing the floor away. Hold it there, breathe in, and you're just gonna lift the elbow up. So you're gonna lift the right elbow, look up, do that twist that we often do. Try and push the floor away. And then breathe in back to center. It's when you breathe out that you're twisting. I think I said breathe in. So just make sure you're breathing out using your core. And then breathing in as you're dropping. We're going to do about 6 more of these. So take it to your rhythm, your own timing. Breathe in. Point your elbow up. Try and get your your arm or your fingers in line with your nipples as you lift. Go in line with your nipples. That's it. And then drop in. Let me see a couple more. Breathing out as you lift. Look up if you can. Breathe in as you drop. And again. Good. When you come to the right side, let's just hold the right arm up, guys. Hold the right elbow up, I'm gonna say. And let's just think of posture here. So look forward, look at me if you can, so you just know what we're doing. Sink into the shoulder and then push away. Sink into the shoulder, yeah, and then push away. Make sure you're always pushing, yeah? And your elbow, if it were an eye, it would be looking up towards the ceiling. Just do one more. And now stay pushing. Now keep it here. Reach your hand up if you can, just for 8 seconds. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And just circle the arm all the way down. And we'll do the same with the other shoulder. One more thing, can I just show you? I don't like taking out of the position, but what I do see is this, look. When we lift one elbow up, the hip goes with it. Because when you're twisting, just to make yourself not work the spine, because it's a little bit harder, your body kind of all moves with that elbow. So what you want to do is isolate just the ribs moving. So when you're lifting the elbow, for example, your right elbow up, you need to push your right hip back. And then same thing. Yeah, that's it, Susan. And then when you're lifting your left elbow up, you need to push your left hip back. It tends to come forward. Yes, now we're doing it. And just check. If your hand is really hanging, I mean, I'm not in your body, so I can't really say. But if it's really hanging from the elbow joint, it should just fold, right? Rather than being tense. Can you make it just relax? Yeah, that looks better. That looks better, Emily. Yes, great. Okay, let's just hold the left side now, thinking of all of that. So you're lifting the left elbow up. Ideally, your chin is in line with your left shoulder one day. And now we're sinking and we're pushing about 3 times more. Sink, think of your left hip, push it back, Susan. Relax the left hand down, down. One more. Good, Emily, that arm looks so much better. And now just hold your arm up or your elbow if you just want to keep the elbow, that's fine. Try and turn your chin all the way, palm facing the left side of the room. Nice, hold it there. Twist now from the ribs. Push your left hip back. And then release. Well done. Okay, coming to your child's pose. Put your hands forward. Pulling on the floor. 3 deep breaths. So as you breathe in, see if you can use your imagination in that position and run up your spine like if you were scanning your spine as you breathe in. Imagine the air is running up your spine like a pipe of water, the water running up or down it. As you breathe out, imagine that there's weight and that you're kind of a balloon that's disinflating and kind of sinking further down, especially from the hips into the floor by using the pump. So let's just think of that again. Breathe in it. And then breathing out. Great. On your next breath in, we're going to come just one more time on our hands and knees. So find that position. I just want to stretch the legs with the twist we've done. And we did this last week. Just see if you can stretch your right leg onto the floor. My toes are on the floor. Even the ball of my foot is slightly on the floor. And now I'm pushing my heel back, so I'm really trying to stretch my calf. As you do this, just check that you're not sinking into the shoulders, that your stomach is still kind of held tight, and you're still working your back, your arm is down. So what I'm doing is shifting forward and back now, just pulling into the heel and then releasing a little bit, pushing back and releasing. Now, all I want you to do is just hold that position where you feel a bit of a stretch in the calf, especially if you wear heels, you're going to sit here. And then maybe, as well as holding that, you could try and lift, if it's your right leg that's stretched, it's your left arm or your left elbow that wants to reach up. See if you want to hold that. And just 8 seconds. If you want an extra challenge, you could even try lifting the right leg all the way up. So 8 seconds. 7. Good. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Nice, guys. Just release it down. We'll do exactly the same with the other leg. If your wrists are getting a bit tired, you could do the first part on your elbows if you want. That's fine also. Just see if it works for you. So toes, it's the left leg, yeah? My toes are against the floor. I'm pushing back. If my wrists are tired, elbows, if not, hands, if not also fists, then you're not flexing the wrist joint. Okay, once you've kind of found a little bit of a stretch in the calf, make sure always your knees pointing down, just letting through those one leg, one arm legs. So we're gonna hold it either here. If you want a little bit more of a stretch, add that twist with it. Just now, just check you're not sinking into the shoulder. It's your right arm that's reaching up if your left leg is back. And now you've always got the option to lift the left leg up. It's 8 seconds. Find your balance. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Lovely. Drop it down. Stretch back into your child's pose again. So maybe you can try opening the knees wide this time if that works for you. And then maybe rather than the head, try and touch your chest bone one day to the floor. That's not easy, so just be patient. And let's really try and again breathe. Imagine it. As you breathe in, you're imagining that breath is running up your spine. So all the way up through your coccyx, lumbar spine, middle spine, cervical spine, up to your head even. That's your breath in. As you breathe out, squeeze your stomach in and push your hips back towards your heels with your core, with your hands. One more. Breathe in. Think of that image. Focus the mind on your spine, on your breath. Breathe it out. Let's do a last one. Breathe in. Me, what's the reason why you steady breathing? Lovely. Okay, we're gonna walk our hands back to our knees, try and roll up as that, and we'll sit at the front of our mat. We're gonna start our core work. If you've got a balloon, see, I'm in a party balloon now with all this funk. I'm asking for balloons instead of balls. A ball or a cushion, guys. A cushion will do. Come at the front of your mat. Squeeze your inner thighs. And make sure you've got that ball in between them. As you squeeze on the exhale, grab your legs. We're just going to do 4 rollbacks and then we'll get on the mat, yeah? So you're breathing in, stretching your spine. Hands behind your legs. Breathe out and roll back. Good, and again, breathe in, stretch your chest up, but not your chin, careful with the chin. Breathe out, roll back. So if you think about it, your chin is always parallel to the floor, it doesn't drop. So as you breathe in, you're going from the crown of your head, chin is parallel to the floor. And then as you breathe out, the only thing that drops is your eyes to look at your stomach, but your chin is still parallel to the floor. Yeah, one more, breathe in it. And breathing out, we're going to go all the way down. So let go of your legs once you've gone to your maximum. And then walk your feet back. Let's go with our arms behind our head. That's our breath in. Breathe out, squeeze the ball, press the hands down by the sides. Let's do that again. Breathe in, arms back. Breathe out. And again, breathing in. Breathing out. Carry on. I'm going to try and put a music that's a little bit... My music is jumping from one thing to the other today. How random. So breathe in, arms back. Breathe out, arms by your sides. And I'll try and find something that helps us move a little bit. I think that one could be good. Exhale down. And inhale up. Yeah. Exhale. In. Or go to your own rhythm, but I would say today especially, let go, feel the music. Breathe in, stretch back. As you want to, if you want to, start lifting your head and shoulders. We're doing 8 more. Inhale, go back. Exhale. Suck the stomach in, squeeze the ball, yeah? Breathe it, go back. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Breathe it. Four more. Breathe it up. Breathe it in. Three more. Breathe it. Exhale up. Breathe it. One more. Breathe it. Okay, just move the hips now. Exhale, lift the tailbone up just a little bit. Inhale, release arms behind your head. So we're going from neutral to imprint, to bending bridge. Exhale, lift the hips just a little bit like we usually do, guys. Inhale, drop the hips down. So your tailbone is lifted, but your middle spine is staying on the floor, and you're trying just to use, just be aware, right? As you exhale, try not to use your glutes to lift your hips up. Try and just suck your stomach in and make the contraction of your rectus, of your core, lift your hips up. It's very different, right? I don't know if you're trying it, I definitely am. And it's hard to not make your glutes work, but it is possible. So that's the idea. Let's do two more like that, and then we can add head and shoulders if your neck doesn't hurt. Please go slower if you find it's too much, because it is quite fast and it's a lot of information. So, lifting the head and shoulders and hips now, eight more as an option, yeah? Breathe in, go back. Breathe out, and in. Breathe in, go back. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. We've got five. Take it easy, guys. Exhale. In. Four more. Inhale, last three more. In, two more. One more. Exhale. Okay, drop the head, but keep your hands on your thighs. We're going into a full bridge now. So breathe in, do nothing. Breathe out, roll up. Roll all the way up into a bridge. Vertebra at a time. Once you're up, you're breathing in, trying to lift as high as you can. And then as you breathe out, you're rolling down. But you're pushing your hands into your thighs to help you kind of resist into that C-shaped spine. Let's try again. Breathe in, do nothing. Breathe out, roll up. Push your feet down, squeeze the balls. Breathe in, can we lift higher? Breathe out, roll down. Okay, let's do a four. Breathe in. Breathe out. Roll up. Push the feet down. Squeeze the inner thighs. Breathe in. Lift a little higher. See if you can lift the hips higher. And then breathe in out. Roll in. Breathe. Breathe in. Breathe out. Good, guys. Push your shoulders into the floor. Open the chest. Breathe in. Stretch the arms. Push the hips up. Breathe out. I'm pushing my hands into my thighs to add like a contraction, a resistance to that C-shaped spine as I'm going down. Yeah? Breathe in. Breathe out. Roll up. So push into your thighs with your hands. Make your hands active. Part of the movement. Inhale. Lift higher. Now as you breathe out, push into your thighs to roll the spine back. And let that resistance help you stretch your groin and kind of resist as you go down. Good. Good. Nice and sad. One more. Breathe in. Breathe out. Roll it up. We're going to stay up now, guys. Squeeze the ball on your exhale always. Keep your hips high. We're just moving our arms. Move your arms all the way behind your head. That's it. See if you can walk your shoulders a little bit closer and lift your heart a little bit higher. Hold it there. Now we're going to move your arms, our arms, for eight. So you're going to exhale like the sit-ups. Hands on the floor though, all the way down. And then breathe in all the way back on the floor. Exhale. Squeeze the ball now. Don't let the hips lower. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. That's four. Breathe in it. Four more. Breathe in out. Squeeze the ball. Breathe in. Breathe up. Breathe in. Two more. Breathe up. Breathe in. One more. Breathe out. Can you hold it here? Hands are down by your hips. Breathe in. As you breathe out, you're rolling all the way down. Palms will face down, but open them up wider than your mat, but lower than your shoulders. Lift the legs up if you want to keep working your core. If not, just keep the feet down and it will rest your lumbar spine too. We want to twist, yeah? So as you breathe in, you're dropping. You know this one. We're dropping our legs to one side, we're looking to the other. That's our breath in. Take a moment here. Try and plump both your shoulder blades into the floor. Breathe out, squeeze the stomach in, and coming back up. And the other side, breathe it in as you drop, look to the opposite direction to where you're going. Great. Breathe out, squeeze your stomach in so you're protecting your spine. Coming back, squeezing the ball. And again, so we're doing about six more. Let me see them. Breathe in out, back to stretch. Breathe it in. Five more. Breathe it out, squeeze the stomach, squeeze the ball. Four more. Breathe out. You know when you turn your head, do about three more and then just hug your legs and let go of the ball. But just see the last two that you're doing. You can really twist your head so much that one day your ear will touch the floor or the side where you're twisting. So you're trying to touch the floor with your ear. Susan, don't cheat, don't cross your feet. Make it your inner thighs that work, not your toes. I caught you. Your feet were right on camera there. Okay, come back to center. Well done. We're just gonna let the ball go for a second. Grabbing our legs, just rolling our legs. So grab each knee with one hand and then draw circles with them. So we wanna do four one way and four the other. And if you don't mind counting it yourselves, and I'll just let you know of something. If you think of your tailbone as you're drawing these circles with your knees, your tailbone tends to rock towards the front of the mat and the back of the mat as you draw the circles. It's quite natural for it to do that. But ideally, in Pilates, you're holding your stomach so tight that your tailbone is not rocking. So try and feel that. Always your tailbone is on the mat, grounded, and you're not moving it as you move your knees. It changes a lot, doesn't it? The movement. So do the circles the other direction. Maybe think of that. If you've already done that, just squeeze your legs in. But it's something to be aware of. These little details are the kind of the most important part of the practice. If not, we could be doing literally anything. Okay, so we've got our legs in, just squeeze them in here. Do a couple of breaths. Breathe in, breathe back, squeeze them a little bit more. And I would like to do these rolls and then swivel into our stomach. So do about four rolls. Remember that you can roll side to side, forward and back. And now the tailbone does roll. So you're rolling and you might feel that there's any tender spots in your spine. Just be slow. Maybe you can even take your legs back into a plow, but be careful. And when you've done your fourth one, you just want to swivel the legs around and let's end on our stomach. So I've got this this new movement. It's not new, I did it for a long time and then I forgot about it. And then I've had a few people with groin injuries, which is very good if you sit down a lot to stretch all that area. I'm not sure if we did it last week, but we're definitely gonna do it now. So ideally, your hands are one on top of the other, your forehead is on the floor, but when you know what you're doing. And what we're gonna do is lift our right leg up. Check it out, we're gonna lift our right leg up. Our legs are hip distance apart. And we're going to draw circles. So we're doing the same as we do on our back. We're drawing circles outwards, eight little circles. And you want to breathe in and out eight times. Then we'll drop it. Then we'll do it with the left. Then we'll do eight in and eight in. Yeah? When you're ready. So forehead on the floor once you you know what you're doing. Make sure you draw the circles that you're not lifting your hips from the floor. Equal pressure, hips and chest. Right, lifting the right leg up. Hold it there and circle it out. Breathe in, breathe out. One and a two. Don't bend the knee. Stretch it. And a three and a four. Make sure your knee is bent. It tends to stretch. Six and a seven and an eight. Make sure your knee is stretched. It tends to bend. That's what I meant to say. Let's go with the left leg. Lift the left leg up and stretch your knee, guys. Breathe in, breathe out. One. And outwards, two, and a three, and a four. Now don't rock from one hip to the other. Four more, and three, and that's your core again, stabilizing you. Two, and one, love. Drop that leg down. Let's lift the right leg up now, circle inwardly. Let me see it this time. So lift it up, and a one, inwards, and a two, and a three. And stretch that knee, four, and four more. Breathe in, breathe out, switch the sound. Ah. One more. Lovely, drop that leg down. Let's go with the left leg. Lift it up, breathe in, and breathe out. Circle inwards, and a one, and a two, and a three. Make sure you're not bending your knees, Susan. Four, three, two, and one, love. Drop the leg down. Just shake your hips, make them wobble on the mat, just give them a bit of a wobble. We're gonna try, just to finish off, we're gonna do with both legs. Eight out, and eight in. So we're lifting both legs up. Yeah, so we try. I'll show you. Emily's looking at me, wonder. It's not hard, it's just the same. So we're just drawing those circles outwards, yeah? Just careful, because I see this a lot, guys. The knees tend to think that they want to do the job, and the hard part is to lift the thighs off the floor. That's where you're working your spine also. Okay, let's do it. Eight circles. Small, nothing big. And lift up, breathe in, and here we go, outwards. One, and a small, and a small. And four more, and three, and two, and one. Love you. Drop it down. Take a moment. Make sure your forehead is down and there's no wrinkles on the back of your neck, unless there's any pain in your neck. That's it, Emily. Okay, let's go. Last one. Breathe in. Lift them up. Be strong. And here we go. Exhale. One. Other way. Other direction. And four more. Four, four. And a three, and a two, and one. Love, drop it down, shake your hips. Stretch your arms forward. We're gonna finish with one arm, one leg stretch on the floor. So your forehead is on the floor all the time, once you know what you're doing, obviously. Your hips also, your chest, equal pressure. That's what you're looking for, through your core. So let's go. Lift your right leg and left arm up. Palm faces in. Stretch that knee, exhale, drop. It's on the breath and we lift. Now, the other leg, the other arm. Breathe in, lift up. Good. Exhale, drop. So we've got six more in your own time. Breathing in as you lift. Keep both hips on the floor. Exhale as you drop. Breathe in as you lift. Exhale as you drop. Four more. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Three more. And last two, can you hold it? So one arm, one leg, hold it for 8 seconds, seven, six, five, feet long, more than up. Four, three, two, one, and drop it down, other leg. It's the last push, guys. Breathe in, lift up. Make yourself longer, go on Susan. Make yourself longer, 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 longer. That's it. Release that. Really nice, well done. See if you can just push your hands into the floor and just do a last stretch. Come through a cat position, make the most of it, and then stretch yourself back. Come back to that breath. You remember, we were breathing in, running up the spine with our mind, with our inner eye. So we're still stretching here. but we're just kind of breathing and really run up our spine with our mind. Imagine our breath is going up our spine, and as you breathe out, just sink the hips down a little more. And just hold it for two more breaths. Breathing out. One more. And breathing out. When you're ready, just roll up to a sitting position. Any comfortable sitting position, just to finish together. Just make sure you can keep your spine straight. Okay, let's finish stretching our neck. So with our right hand, just pull your head to the side because we have moved it faster than usual. I don't want your necks hurting tomorrow. So just lightly pull the head down. If this hand helps on your shoulder, keep it. Might not help, might just ride the shoulder up. So just let it go. See what works for you. I find that if I push them the opposite way, I feel a bit more of the stretch. And then come back up. Before you go to that side, turn your head, put your hat on, and nod your chin down. Feel the back of your neck stretch there. And then back up. Let's go to the other side. So grab with your left hand, pull your head to the left, your shoulder with the right, if that helps. As we do this, our chest bone sometimes goes with the movement. Let me see. Sometimes I see kind of a sinking. Yeah. The idea is to think of your chest bone always lifting up when you're stretching your neck. And also when you're doing the other movement, it happens a lot there. So just be aware of that. I'll remind you. Breathe in.